Welcome back everybody to 365 Days of Prague. Today we will be listening to New World by Dave Kersner.
Hi, my name's Naomi. I'm an avid progressive rock fan, but I'm a long ways from knowing all the Prague albums out there. But this year, I'm gonna give it a try. This is 365 Days of Prague.
Now, before we get into this album, I want to share with you my favorite bits from this album, so strap on, listen to those, and I'll see you all afterwards. This album is by the artist Dave Kersner. Now, I say that with a grain of salt because this album also features so many other guest people that play on it. So yeah, guest people is now a thing and they play on this album. And a lot of them are pretty well known, like there's a lot of people that come from Yes and Big Big Train, and there's EOP, and there's more in this album, so you're gonna expect to get much out of this piece. Now, the way I'm gonna dissect this album, I'm actually gonna talk about the tracks beforehand, and then I'm gonna talk about what I think about the overall experience. So the first track on this album, it's called Stranded, and it is a five-parter, and it's trying to tell a beginning of a story. Now, the story we're getting into is about a man who crash lands, I think, in the middle of a desert. This is a deserty planet, and everyone lives in those kind of like biospheres on this planet because living outside is just too dangerous, I suppose. And the fact is, this album is basically his journey from where he got stranded to get back to his home in his own biosphere. Now, I think this is not doing a great job at it. I think this song in particular is trying to tell a story using mostly instruments, although it does have some lyrics. I think it does try and make you feel the journey the character is going through. But I think this track does not really do so that well. It is kind of repetitive. It doesn't really feature a lot of different motives that make me believe that this character is going through a journey right now when he's stranded. I just don't feel like I'm really getting that vibe of a story. And this thing is gonna last with us for the entirety of this album. I just don't think this album actually does a good job at telling a story mostly instrumentally. And when it comes to the lyrics, it might as well do so, but it doesn't worth anything if I cannot believe the effect and the environment and everything that's going on with the music that plays on the tracks. By the way, apparently Steve Hackett, the well-known guitarist of band Genesis, played on this song, and I cannot hear that. Like, you would expect to hear such a marvelous player playing on a track, but no, this is just not doing it for me. And overall, I think this track sounds more like a closing piece for an album than an opening piece, which is also pretty odd. So the second track on this album is called Into the Sun. Now, this is the first song which I really find to be uninspiring in some way, because unlike the first song which focused on the instrumentals, this song just loses all that when the singing comes in. It just sounds like there's a set drum beat in the background, nothing really interesting is going on as long as someone is singing, and I think that just kind of ruins the entire experience. I don't like it when an album just gives up on the musical part when it comes to someone singing. Now, from tracks 3 all the way to track 8, I think this album just really goes downhill. Now, by this point, you know what I'm thinking of this album. I don't really enjoy it, but wait a second, don't go quite yet, because this album has something really odd in it. It gets better, believe me, okay? So as I said, the tracks between 3 and 8, they're not really that interesting. Like, I was really trying my hardest to dissect them and understand them more and try and get the environmental feeling of this album, but I just didn't get none of that. Those tracks were completely boring, in my opinion. Now, apparently Keith Emerson, the freaking legendary Keith Emerson, was playing on the Moog in track 5, but as well as Steven Hackett, I just did not hear that coming in. You just didn't have what you would expect from such a marvelous player. But as I said, after track 8 is completed, I think the other two tracks, or I think three tracks, those tracks, they're actually pretty good. So coming into track 9, it's called Nothing. It does have some redeeming features, but I think the track that really fairly blew me away in this album was actually the 10th track, self-titled New World. Now, that track is actually one I really enjoyed listening to, and I've actually replayed it a few times since I've heard it first. It's a really good song. I think it works musically. I still don't think it's stellar in any way. I just think it's good. And that actually says a lot when it comes to this album. So that's all I have to say about the mostly individual tracks on this album. They're not that interesting. Now I'm gonna dive way more into why I think this is a lackluster experience. Going on websites and looking at reviews for this album, you always see that the reviews are actually pretty freaking positive for this album, like for its entirety. And the reason is all around, yeah, you guessed it, or maybe you didn't, it's because of Pink Floyd. Now, you might be asking yourself, why is Pink Floyd have anything to do with this album? Now, apparently this album came out in 2014, and another thing that happened in 2014 was that Pink Floyd released their last album to date, called The Endless River. As we departed from Pink Floyd and they disbanded, we get this album that most people claim sounds like what Pink Floyd would have been if they did not disband. Now, I have to disagree with that. I think that this album might have some qualities that sound like Pink Floyd. I would say that Dave Kirzner's voice does sound kinda like David Gilmour's, but I don't think that's enough to actually resemble the two bands altogether. I think, if I must say, that this whole album actually sounds more like a Steven Wilson album to me. Yeah, I know, I don't know why. It just sounds like, I think, the raven that refused to sing, mostly. And that's the vibe I'm getting from it. And only later did I research about this album and I saw that many people think that this is a complete continuation for what Pink Floyd could have done. And while the main point of many of the reviewers of this album is that it sounds like Pink Floyd and many people don't like it because it sounds like Pink Floyd and many people like it because it, well, sounds like Pink Floyd, I think that both sides are completely wrong, because thinking about Pink Floyd's discography and looking at their later work, you'd see that it's not as good as their earlier work. At least most people think that albums such as The Wall and Dark Side of the Moon and Animals and Echoes are better than albums like A Momentary Lapse of Reason and of course The Endless River. Now, saying that this album sounds like later Pink Floyd work is good and all, but I don't think it stands up to those standards that Pink Floyd has put up in the past. And the other point I was saying, this album tries to tell a story. It has like a really solid idea. I just don't think it does any good job of doing so. I don't feel the story. I don't experience the story. I don't experience the environment. I did not know there was a story. The only way I knew what to expect is because I read about this album a bit on Wikipedia before listening to it, so I could know that there was a concept to this album. But other than that, I don't think I felt this narrative going in this album. And yeah, I must say, this album has so many unique and genuinely great instrumentalists on it from so many different bands, and the fact that I could listen to this entire album and not be wowed because of it is just so disappointing in some way. You would think that so many great musicians on this album would make it a stellar album and that I would appreciate, but no, it's not. And I would actually appreciate this album more if it was only made by Dave Kirzner, because then it would at least be a one-man job and I could appreciate him doing basically everything. So as you could guess, I don't really like this album all that much, and that seems like an unpopular opinion. If you think otherwise, you can write it down in the comments. I would love to hear your reasoning for it. I am gonna listen to this album, I think, once more to try and see if I can find anything better that I like about it, but for now, this is my opinion. Now, before we move on to the rating of this album, we have to talk about the cover. Now, the cover itself, it's pretty reminiscent of what you'd hear on this album. It shows you that there's a desert, it shows you that it's a long ways from the biosphere, which means our character basically has to go a long ways until he's saved. I don't think the composition is really all that great, and I don't think the colors are all that great. It is on the verge of looking realistic but also looking like very photoshopped, and I think they could have went with One Direction mainly. So they could have chosen to make this cover look more like a drawing of what it is, or they could have really tried and making it look very realistic. And I would even say they could have gone as far as to actually build like a set, or at least a miniature set, that then would really look like there's a desert and a city in the background and of course the sky. So all in all, this album receives a 5 out of 10 from me. Now, a 5 is a decent score, that's what I would call it. I think I might have given it a lower score, but I think the last few tracks on this album actually redeemed it in some way or another. And I think that's pretty good, because this album is not bad, I just really find it disinteresting. So, stay tuned for tomorrow, we'll be listening to Romantic Warrior by the band Return to Forever. It's a really interesting album, I actually already gave it a listen, so I know what I'm gonna say about it, and believe me, it's gonna be good. So until then, I'll see you all tomorrow. Bye guys.